massive softball-sized hail broke car windows and caused damage to several buildings. One person was killed and around 100 others were injured when high winds caused a tent to collapse near Busch Stadium. Now, that incident has some questioning the safety of tents used for outdoor events. For the rest of the year, it's quite likely you'll be at some kind of event where tents will be used. So we asked KMBC 9's Micheal Mahoney to find out how safe big event tents can be. Micheal, what'd you find out?
Well, Lara, it requires a permit to erect a big rental tent, and obviously, as we saw over this weekend, strong winds and big tents are problematic.
10 years ago, a strong fall storm hit the tents surrounding the American Royal hard. Because in a sense, they're really just big umbrellas.
It's very, very hard to keep an umbrella on the ground, no matter how much weight you got on it.
Hinky owns Big T's Tents. He has more than 100 large tents of various sizes that he rents. He and every other tent company are now heading into their busy season. And when a tent goes up, they pay a lot of attention about how to hold it down.
We'll look at, with our pole tents, I mean, we will get extra long stakes. Instead of the typical 3-foot stakes, we'll put 4-foot stakes in the ground. We'll multiply the number of stakes we have.
Now, this tent's at Royal Stadium. It'll probably be up for most of the baseball season. And it's easy to tell that it was erected with the idea it would be up for a while. Now, Henke says inspectors don't look at the structure of a tent so much. They're interested in something else.
It's mostly for flame resistance or flame retardants, let's say. Whenever we get a permit issued or one of our clients get a permit issued, that's primarily the only thing that's really looked at.
And the reason for that, of course, is the proliferation of tents in this area has firework stands and something that starts to pop up in the weeks and days right in front of Independence Day. We're live. Now back to you.
All right. Very interesting. Thanks, Micheal. And the owner of the tent company in Michael's report says if you're caught in a storm with high winds, try to find some other kind of shelter other than a tent.